I'm going to make a motion that we decline this in light of the importance of setting a good example to our staff and to the citizens that we are indeed taking our fiscal responsibility seriously. So I would make a motion that we not introduce ordinance 2010-06.
Second.
Any more discussion?
Jerome seconded.
Okay.
Any discussion? I'm ready to vote.
Okay. All in favor? Okay. I'm opposed.
So that was 4-1. Sorry, 4-1.
Okay.
Actually, make that a 3-2 because I thought maybe there was a middle ground, but yeah, I can make it a 3-2.
Yeah, council subcommittee recommendation regarding possible adjustments to the city manager's contract. We had two members on that subcommittee, two reports. I assume you're each going to, okay, well, I imagine you're each going to make a report. Who wants to go first, or how do we want to work this? Okay.
I don't need to reread everything that I put in here. I just feel that I don't recommend an increase to the city manager's pay and benefits for fiscal years 09-10 and fiscal years 10-11. And I say that primarily because that is exactly what he has put in the budget for those exact years, and has made a point of calling that out in the budget executive summary. So I know that he has been highly praised for the zero-based budgeting, and as well as for the way he has handled all of our budgeting this past few years. And so I'm going to take the man at his word, and if he says no raise, then I say no raise as well.
Okay. Jerome.
Well, thank you. I really like my report, so I'm going to go ahead and read it. I request that the council please consider my recommendations and reasoning as follows, except that I just scooted it a whole page. It's following a little longer than I thought it would. Here we go. Please consider my recommendations and reasoning as follows. During the latter portion of 09, the city council determined that it was appropriate to review and discuss the performance of City Manager Phil Cotton, since he had not received a formal evaluation since May of 2007. The evaluation process began in October of 2009 and was comprised of an extensive formal evaluation by each council member that encompassed the following areas. Before I get to the individual characteristics, professional skill and status, relations with elected officials, policy execution, reporting, citizen relations, staffing, supervision, fiscal management, and community. I want to point out that Mr. Cotton did not request this evaluation. The City Council decided that it was something we needed to do. The evaluation process concluded November 14 of 2009 with the majority of the council concluding that the performance of Mr. Cotton as city manager over the last 2.5+ years had not only met but exceeded expectations. First appointed as city manager in September of 06, Mr. Cotton left his position as Director of Public Works for the City of Encinitas and accepted the position of city manager, a demanding position requiring knowledge of city finances and functions, skill, sensitivity, and ability to navigate through the many challenges facing local government. Mr. Cotton accepted this challenge with enthusiasm, dedication, and a focus on service to the community at a salary substantially below that of other city managers in comparable cities throughout the region. In May of 07, after serving his first 8 months as city manager, Mr. Cotton received a performance evaluation. At this point, the City Council recognized the performance of Mr. Cotton and, desiring to retain his services, increased his compensation to a level more comparable to city managers throughout the region. Since that time, Mr. Cotton has continued to lead and guide the city as the chief administrative officer in an exemplary manner, with an ever-present focus on the best interests of the community. During the last 2.5+ years, Mr. Cotton has provided wise counsel to the City Council and city staff in the formulation and adoption of policies and strategies that have allowed the city to be in sound fiscal position, which we heard this evening, while ensuring the council's highest strategic priorities, public safety, infrastructure improvements and maintenance, and core services to our citizens and businesses, are continuously met. Additionally, he did all that while saving $3.9 million in operating expenses from what was originally budgeted, and his leadership has helped the City Council achieve full funding of the city's contingency reserve and establishment of revenue stabilization reserve to account for fluctuations in revenue. Throughout these last 2.5+ years, our miscellaneous employees, represented by SEIU, have received increases in basic pay of 7%, 3.5 for each calendar year 08, 09, and they got another 3.5% last month, as a matter of fact, bringing them to 10.5% over the past 3 years, roughly. Our firefighters, which is a different bargaining unit, have received raises equaling 10.2% for the last 2 calendar years. The City Council has and continues to recognize the importance of maintaining compensation for our city employees at the market median in order to maintain a stable, competent, and productive workforce. Based on the City Council's positive evaluation of the City Manager's performance, the desire of the Council to retain his continued services, and the fact that his compensation has not been adjusted since May of 2007, I recommend the following. I recommend that the City Manager's base salary be increased effective January 1, 2010 by 11%, or $21,859, and that he be provided a 1% increase in his deferred compensation, bringing the total amount of contributed to his deferred comp to 10% of his base salary, or $4,173, bringing his total compensation for services rendered to $242,640, which is commensurate and consistent with the compensation afforded comparable city managers in our region. And I would include a thank you for a job well done.
Has 9 months. If he leaves or the city tells him to leave, which I don't see it happening in the near future, instead of the 6 month severance package, his was bumped up to 9 months without really much discussion. In fact, wasn't discussed. But anyway, I'm not saying that's right or wrong, but even in our most times when we've been the most comfortable financially, we've always wanted to see comparables. I don't want to say yay or nay. I want to look, see what's there, see what possibilities there are. But I will say that I get to talk. I had my hand up. I want to say that I would like to see those comparables. I want to be fair, but I don't want to take a position without doing the normal process.
I think that was Jerome.
Would the motion maker be okay with the first meeting in March instead of next week?
Fine.
Yeah. Do we even need a motion or just consensus here?